Praise the Lord. Hey everyone, good to see you all. Currently, we are living in the world swamped with negative things. So most of them are in a fix and flummoxed with negative thoughts, depression, sluggishness, lack of energy and so on. So in this video, let me talk about how to overcome the negative thoughts according to Bible, which is a stupendous book that we can't put it down. Let's get going with a short prayer. Lord Almighty, you speak through me. In the name of Jesus, Amen. Before jumping into the topic, let me brief some basic truth from the Bible. Genesis 1:26 clearly says, God, the Father, Son and Holy Spirit made mankind in His own image. Basically, three things cultivated in the man by God. Firstly, His own image. Secondly, God gave the complete authority to the man. Thirdly, God was keeping connection with a man through his seventh sense. Meanwhile, man was cheated by serpent and man ate the fruit which was not advised by the Lord. And as soon as after eating the fruit, man lost those three things given by God. He lost God's own image and worldly eyes opened in him. Number two, he lost the authority given by the God. Number three, his seventh sense too cut off. So God couldn't connect with him and God was searching, where are you, Adam? After that, so many things happened. Then God sent judges, kings, prophets to deliver the man from the hands of devil. But it ended in failure. So God himself sent his word and born us Jesus Christ and deliver you and me from the hands of devil. Colossians 1:20 clearly says, through the blood of Jesus Christ in the cross, God reconciled everything, the things both in the world and heaven. So here is the gospel. Through the blood of Jesus Christ, we regained those three things we lost, that Adam lost in the garden. We gained in the cross. Number one, we gained God's image so that spiritual eyes opened in him, in us. And number two, we got the authority that we lost in that garden. And number three, we got back our seventh sense so that we can hear God's voice, we can talk with God. And God gave the Holy Spirit, the wonderful counselor, comforter, intercessor, strengthener, standby. In Matthew 7:21, Jesus Christ is saying, not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of heaven, but he who does the will of my Father who is in heaven. So what is the will of the God? The answer is in Ephesians chapter 4 verses 13. Till we all come in the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God into a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. We should become the stature of Jesus Christ. That is the will of the God in our life. Romans 8:29 says, Jesus Christ is the firstborn. And Hebrews 2:11 says, Jesus Christ is not ashamed to say, those who are believing in his cross death as brethren, as that is brothers and sisters. So Jesus Christ is our brother. He is our role model. He is our king and he is our hero too. He set an example how to live in this world and how to overcome the negative things. So we are supposed to live like him. So let's see what is the mindset of Jesus while he was living in this earth. Two secrets I am happy to share about it. Number one secret, Jesus Christ knew about the mentality of human beings. Secret number two, mind is an essential and important thing in both physical and spiritual life. Number one, he knew about the mentality of human beings. John chapter 2 verses 23, 24 and 25 says, now when he was in Jerusalem at the Passover in the feast day, many believed in his name when they saw the miracles which he did. But Jesus did not commit himself unto them, because he knew all men, and needed not that any should testify of man, for he knew what was in man. Jesus knew about human beings. Numbers chapter 23 verses 19 clearly says, God is not a man that he should lie. So don't trust human beings and words of human beings. If we put more trust in human beings, ultimately it will end up in failure. When you do something good to man, he used to praise you, and if he couldn't, he used to blame you. That is the actual mentality of human beings. We can't satisfy the human beings in this world. Instead, we Christians called to trust only God. Psalms 118:8 crystally clearly saying this: it is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. Jesus said this big truth in his mind so that he couldn't get hurted by any human beings while he was living in this world. Secret number two, mind is an essential and important thing in both physical and spiritual life. Our mind rules our body. Our body is attached to the mind. What we think, what we act, what we react, what we speak, all according to the direction of our mind. Paul, the apostle of God, clearly says in 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verses 4, "For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds." If we keep more connection with the world, the negative information from the world will become the strongholds in our mind. So Jesus Christ, while he was living in this world, he was keeping constantly connected with the God, not in the worldly things. And Jesus Christ fixed in his mind so to fulfill the will of the God. Same way, we also got the mindset of Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 2:16 says, "For who hath known the mind of the Lord that he may instruct him? But we have the mind of Christ." So we hold the thoughts, feelings and purposes of Jesus Christ. And one more big secret Jesus Christ is teaching in Matthew chapter 6 verses 20 and 21. Jesus Christ said to store the eternal treasures in the heaven. So we should know what is the meaning of eternal treasures and what is the meaning of heaven biblically. Number one, eternal treasures. Colossians, the answer is in Colossians chapter 3 verses 2. That is called eternal treasures are above, whereas Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Just imagine if God is sitting and Jesus Christ is sitting at next to him, right side of the God, and through Jesus Christ we can sit behind Jesus Christ, and how God will see us through his cross. So eternal treasures are the word of God that achieved in the cross through Jesus Christ. That is called eternal treasure. And what is the meaning of heaven biblically? It is the kingdom of God. In Luke chapter 17 verses 21, Jesus Christ explained it neatly. "Neither shall they say, lo here or lo there, for behold, the kingdom of God is within you." In Amplified version, it also clearly states that it is in your hearts. So what Jesus Christ said, to store the eternal treasures in the heaven. So eternal treasures, that is the word of God achieved in the cross through Jesus Christ. We should store those Bible verses, those word of God in our mind. For example, if you feel sick, the answer solution is in Isaiah 53, "Through his stripes we got healed." So when you confess more and more this word of God, this word of God will fill in your mind and you can receive the healing. Likewise, we can search a lot of word of God in the Bible and we can apply in all our negative aspects of the life. Let me read Hebrews 8:10. "For this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, saith the Lord. I will put my laws into their mind and write them in their hearts, and I will be to them a God, and they shall be to me a people." So mind is an essential thing. This is the reason devil is unnecessarily installing some negative thoughts in our mind. His devil's ultimate aim is to separate us from God. So if we know this big secret, it is very simple and easy to get rid of negative things, negative thoughts, depression and so on. So fill in your mind with more word of God, which will give you more positive energy. Jesus Christ is a suave guy, and we got his mindset through his cross death. So we can also easily win this world. We can easily overcome the negative situations, and we can overcome the negative thoughts. Alright guys, so I am ending this video. Feel free to comment me for any prayer request. God bless you all. Amen.